Dutch first violinist Christian van Echelen is the kind of person that every orchestra needs as a member. He's a great guy, he's a fantastic violinist, but what we're about to find out is that he's also an extremely important person in the organization. But first, when I first met you, mate, your English was amazing. I mean, I really thought you were English. Where does that accent come from?
I lived in England. I was born in Delft, but then moved to England. Then I subsequently, after about 4 or 5 years, I went to Belgium and I did my studies in Berlin and then came back to Amsterdam.
Wow. So. You started studying in Berlin, where you're a prize winner, foreign student of the year. We don't have to discuss it if you don't like, in such a modest guy. But the studying in Berlin eventually led to you playing with the Berlin Philharmonic.
That's right, yeah. My teacher, he did a gig with some of the Berlin Phil members, and somebody had called in sick and they needed a replacement. I'd always loved the Berlin Phil so much. I mean, it'd always been a dream for me to play with the Berlin Phil day. So, yeah, they called me and I did a week and then I did 2 weeks and then we went to Japan and did the festival tour and played with Abbado and with Haitink, and, I mean, it was great stuff.
And this was your first professional orchestral experience?
Yeah, and they actually paid me for it. I loved it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, and they've been asking for the money back ever since.
The money's gone. It's well spent.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, I think it's fair to say that the Berlin Philharmonic absolutely is in the top 10 orchestras in the world, as apparently are we. What are the differences from inside?
I think one of the biggest differences maybe is because of the different halls. Philharmonie in Berlin, it's a little bit like the Mercedes S-Class. It's just every button works, you know, and you just press it and it'll do what it's supposed to do.
Yeah.
Whereas Concertgebouw, it's like the Rolls-Royce. You know, you have the space to wear your crown and you sit there and there's some squeaks and stuff, but it's royal.
Yeah. Do you miss playing with Berlin? I mean, obviously you're busy here, so you don't get to go there so often now.
But I should be honest and really say, I mean, I love being at home. And because I recognise also the Dutch mentality. And there's just an enormous amount of humour also in the... Yeah. In Dutch we have this word self-spot, so self-humour taking the mick out of yourself. Yeah. I mean, it's something that we're very good at.
Yeah, absolutely. Your role within the orchestra, though, is not just as a great first violinist. Can you just explain to us, how is the orchestra set up? What is your role within that at the moment?
To start off with, we have the musicians and the staff members, and they're all part of an association. And this is called the Vereniging het Concertgebouw Orkest. And it has a board, and I'm the lucky one to have been chosen as chairman. Now, my main big job is to negotiate working agreements on behalf of the musicians and the staff members with the management board. And with them, we agree upon, salaries, holidays, bus trips, all of this kind of things. To supervise all of this, we have the big board above all, which is the supervisory board, if you like. It's called the Stichtingsbestuur. Mm-hmm. Now, this consists of about 10 chairs, and these are all very intelligent, clever people running big companies, the banks, the lawyers. They're from outside. 10 chairs, 7 of which are these very clever people, 3 of which are actually musicians from the orchestra. Mandatory, the chairman of the Vereniging has to be in the Stichtingsbestuur. The funny thing is that on the one hand, I have to negotiate with the managing directors, and on the other hand, I have to kind of like supervise the whole well-being of the orchestra. So if I do my job well and negotiate them for us to offer far too much money and to pay us and to give us too much holidays. when I'm on the other board, I'm supposed to tell them off and say, well, you did that terribly bad and that's going to ruin the orchestra.
And how do you get time to do that? I mean, you're a full-time violinist.
I did also negotiate with the managing board that they give me a little bit of time off from the playing, so I play 10% less services. And so that's really nice. I have enough time to do the things and sort it out.
Well, I've seen you grow into this job, and I have to say that you negotiate the path, a very difficult path, a lot of the time, because we're all relying on you extremely well. So I for one, must say this out in the open that I'm extremely grateful.
Thank you for your kind words.
And your, like you're not busy enough, thing is chess. We see we see you in the pause, in the interval of concerts, immediately chessboard out, timer ready, and you're banging out a couple of games of chess whilst everyone else is sort of having coffee.
I mean, you can. It's like music. You can get lost in it. You know, once you start practicing, when you're in that flow, you're in your own bubble.
But you also play chess with visiting conductors as well.
Yeah, we do. Some of them really enjoy the game as well and are really good at it. For example, Ivan Fischer.
He's good, isn't he?
Oh, he's so creative at the board. It's fantastic.
Isn't there one of the security guards at the Concertgebouw also he's a big player?
He's really good. Yeah, he always wins, yeah.
Yeah, great. Christian, thank you, mate. Thank you so much for speaking to me, and thank you for all the work you do for the orchestra.
Thank you for your kind words, and thank you for having me, Dominic.